very pleased to welcome you. My name is Pizzocra, I'm the president of Guna. We know each other, some of you we know already, since many years. So I give a special welcome to the people who's here for the first time. We have people from the different area of the world. Also, it's a very good satisfaction for us. We have person from Ireland, from England, from Ukraine, from Georgia, from Guatemala, Bolivia, Colombia, Mexico, and Georgia, and Guatemala. So it's a, very, it's a little United Nations based on the new paradigm of medicine. So especially for the person who are here for the first time, I would like to give a few information about the company, about the history of the company, which was founded already 33 years ago. Time is passing very quickly. And was founded by my wife and myself. My wife, she was a researcher, she was a pharmacist, and before she was working in the research of the most important Italian pharmaceutical company. And I had a little import-export business, so we decided to, and both of us got in love with each other, but also with homeopathy. We were fond of homeopathy, so we decided to left our previous business and we started from zero with our Guna, which is now the most important Italian company in the field of natural medicine. So we started, we were lucky because we had the chance to import the German company Hale. At the moment was not, they are not represented in Italy, so we started with them. We started since the beginning working with translation, publishing, and organizing seminars. This is still our main way to make our business. And then, so we developed in this way. In this way, we were able to gather a group of medical doctors who were experts in homeopathy, and together we organized really a lot of meetings, seminars, and we started also a 3-year tour on homotoxicology. But we had also in this way, together, we had the feeling or the need to build something different. We had ideas to make homeopathy more modern, or let's say more in accordance with the new scientific development. So we decided to open our own laboratory, and that was in 89. It was the first homeopathic laboratory approved by Italian Ministry of Health. It was a very little laboratory, but we started to introduce new concepts. So we started to produce homeopathic products coming from hormones, from cytokines. And this approach was not easy, but step by step has been accepted by the medical community. And so we started to expand in this kind of our own laboratory. We had to move. Our first laboratory was not big enough. We had to move to another laboratory. And eight years ago, we moved to the laboratory where we're producing now our medicine, which you are going to visit tomorrow. And you will see that we try to do our best to make it the most up-to-date technically and also from aesthetic point of view. We are a family company, so we like to do things in the right way, in the way that things will last for the future. So we started our export business. This was about 12, 13 years ago, and now, thanks to the great work of our distributor, in different parts of the world. We are now present in over 30 different countries, and we have also a subsidiary in the United States. Our products, we have 70 products which are registered or notified at FDA, and step by step we are going to register also in many, many other different countries. As I mentioned, our main target has always been to be dedicated to teaching and to research. So now we can say that every year we organize in Italy and abroad more than 600 days of teaching. And these teaching are held by doctors to other doctors. And we believe this is the best way to develop this new concept of medicine. But then also we started several years ago to work deeply for in the field of research, medical and scientific research. Also, this at the beginning was not easy because our approach is not inside the mainstream of science. And so our first study, to Alessandro will remember, was very, very, gave us a lot of suffering because they didn't accept the paper, they wanted to know a lot of things. At the end, we got the first paper in 2009, in a peer-reviewed magazine, scientific accepted. So after the first one, the second one was easier, the third was even easier, and now we have, and Alessandro will show you in details all the status, we have 16 plus 2, which are going to come.
Yeah.
And all these are in a peer-reviewed magazine. And I know that we are the only homeopathic company who is so much devoted to research and got so many good results. That's the way why we can talk to everybody. We can talk to doctors which is homeopathic background, but we can talk also to any kind of medical doctors. We have good relationship with professor from university in Italy and not only in Italy, and together with them we are going to organize more and more masters inside the university. And it's funny because now they are coming to us often and they ask to help them, to help the university to organize teaching in this field. Because it's clear now that the doctors are willing to know more about low-dose medicine. So I am also to say that I'm grateful to you because you are the pioneer, or you have been the pioneer in this field. You are from since many years, some of you, especially our distributors, have followed us in our difficult step. And we hope that we shall get more and more success in spite of the difficulties that we are going to face, especially in terms of registration and the bureaucratic problems. But as we know that our product, our theory, our approach to medicine is the right one, is successful, get good result, for sure we are going to develop and get more and more results. So thank you again for having been with us for today and tomorrow. This morning Alessandro will talk about the latest development and research in our field. In the afternoon, Professor Passaparo will talk about the gynecology problem, and then the day two, which will go on also today tomorrow, and then Alessandro will go on in the morning, tomorrow,
yeah.
And then in the afternoon, you will have the chance to visit our laboratory, which we are not so far away from here. But last but not least, we are waiting for you this evening for our dinner, gala dinner, in this same hotel. So now I'm very happy to leave you to Alessandro, and I hope you will be strong enough to follow these 2 days of teaching. But Alessandro will keep you awake for sure. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Pizzocchero, and thank you, everybody, to be here after, for some of you, a long trip. And as Dr. Pizzocchero said, the program is very intense, but I strongly believe in learning and having fun. So my wish is that you will have fun today, learning something new, something really very, very interesting about physiological regulating medicine and low-dose pharmacology. The program of the 2 days has changed a little because tomorrow was in the program Dr. Lupardini speaking about psychiatry, but he had a problem and he is not able to reach Milan, so Dr. Passafaro, who will speak this afternoon about gynecology, will extend his part focusing on hypofertility tomorrow. And tomorrow I will keep on going on this topic of today. So a little change. Anyway, you have in your syllabus the slides of Dr. Lupardini about psychiatry. Anyway, it will be a chance to come to Milan once again to listen to Dr. Lupardini. This is the menu of today. As you can see, it's very, very intense, as I told you. And since some of you are already into the matter, but maybe some other know, I want just to wrap up in 15 minutes the basis to better understand the action mechanism of our medications. And since we are focusing especially on inflammation, as we say, mother of all the diseases, through this matter, we will make a picture of the basis of PRN. And especially, this is the future, we have invested a lot in research, and some researches are really very, very new. And I'm very happy to share with you the results of all this big work. Especially, we have many publications in oncology, especially in early stage colorectal carcinoma. We are involved with a study which is ongoing on fibromyalgia. Very recent, the results on hand and knee osteoarthritis, especially erosive osteoarthritis of hand. What I did? Oh, maybe I have to touch it. Okay, perfect, I didn't know. Okay. Gout, okay. Where we don't have any treatment. Yes, we have colchicine and allopurinol, but side effects are very severe and the results with that treatment is not so nice. Recurrent respiratory infections, so for all the pediatricians, I will show you the results of our preclinical research, psoriasis and vitiligo. And yesterday I was in Rome at the Policlinico Gemelli, which is a big university in Rome connected to the Vatican, where the Pope goes to be visited, just to understand, because with them we are performing a preclinical, and very soon we will start with the clinical trial on endometriosis, with a very nice concept that is the overlapping between conventional treatment, progesterone 2.5 milligram, plus our medications to reduce the administration of progesterone from 2.5 milligram to 1.25 milligram, and this is a big result. And I will show you some of the preclinical data that are very, very interesting in terms of management of the low-grade chronic inflammation that we always observe in this disease. So we have a lot of things to see, to do. Maybe some of them we will see tomorrow. As Dr. Pizzoccaro told you, in the last 10 years we have invested a lot of energy, both intellectual and financial, in research. And today we can offer to the scientific community 16 plus 2 preclinical studies or clinical trial. Why plus 2? Because today is Friday, no, Thursday. On Monday I have been informed that two papers have been accepted and are in press. One on rheumatoid arthritis, a clinical trial, and another about the wound healing with low dose of acetylcholine. So I already prepared 16, yesterday I had plus 2 to be very updated, as always in science we have to be. Beside the preclinical and clinical trials, PRM is becoming very, very known by the community, by the scientific community, and sometimes we are surprised to know that someone performed an overview or a meta-analysis or something like speaking about what is happening in the field of low-dose medicine. So, beside the preclinical and clinical trials, we also had over 20 overviews and reviews, all of them published in index magazines, obviously. These are, just to have an idea, a chromatic idea of the publication we have and which are the journals. Obviously, they are peer-reviewed journals, indexed and impact journals. Some of them with a very interesting impact factor. I'm very affective related to the first one, 2009, Pulmonary Pharmacology and Therapeutics, about the use of interleukin-12 and gamma interferon in an animal model of allergic asthma. We spent over 2 years to be published, but since this paper has been published on a so important journal, all the other ones were very, not very, but much easier, because we had the first reference about something crazy, that is the use of a substance below the minimal effective pharmacological dose, that is our concentration of active principles. In terms of oncology, we will speak today about that, 3 publications, International Immunopharmacology, about the use of gamma interferon in early stage colon rectal carcinoma. Translational Oncology, this is very recent, it's a very complete study I will show to you, about the sequential use of interleukin-4 and interleukin-12 enhancing the activity of antigen-presenting cells, dendritic cells, that means increasing the immune response in early-stage colorectal carcinoma. This is the continuation of this one. Journal of Cancer Therapy, the use of interleukin-12 in lung carcinoma non-small cells. But interesting also gastroenterology research, one of the papers I love more, about the use of interleukin-10 and anti-interleukin-1 in a model of IBD, inflammatory bowel disease, especially in that case it was a Crohn. Then, you know, we focus our attention on dermatology, and Journal of Biological Regulators, Dermatologic Science, again, Journal of Biological Regulators, and this is a very important German magazine, Der Hautarzt, about psoriasis and vitiligo. And they are very, very complete studies, because both for psoriasis vulgaris and vitiligo, they are preclinical and clinical. And when for vitiligo, you can show a repigmentation between 74 and 90% of the surface, that's a really a very important goal. And so on other, few weeks ago, even this magazine, that is a veterinary magazine, about the use of interleukin-12 and gamma interferon in feline herpes virus. No cure for those poor cats. 100% of positive results. So really, we have a big critical mass of journals nowadays, and this is the reason why now we are accepted into the universities. We are performing second level masters in three Italian universities, Rome, Verona, and once again in another university in Rome. So really, since this is my life, 24 hours a day, 365 days per year, I can tell you that just 10 years ago, that was crazy to think to be inside of the universities. It means that something is changing in the medical paradigm, and we are under the spotlight of the scientific community, and we are very happy for that. I think that the big impulse to be finally considered has become from these publications. In your syllabus, you have all the details of our studies already published in the yellow ones, according to the year. Submitted papers. Look, this is one of those plus two. Migliore Alberto, who is a very famous rheumatologist of the Rome University. We have been just published, we are impressed, treatment of rheumatoid arthritis with anti-interleukin-1, interleukin-10, and interleukin-4. And we are speaking about rheumatoid arthritis. Even in this case, a very smart approach, that is the overlapping of therapy. The clinical trial design was that the patients were under biological medications, anti-TNF-alpha. You know that after 4 or 6 months of infliximab, you have to stop the therapy, and to keep low the activity of disease, you must provide to the patient with medications that are DMARDs. But the side effects of these DMARDs can be very strong. So one branch was treated with DMARDs, the other branch was treated with low-dose cytokines. In terms of not inferiority of the treatment, we reach the primary endpoint. And in terms of absolute values, the treatment with the low-dose cytokines was better than DMARDs. So that's a huge result. And this is a very nice approach, the overlapping, because we know very well that when you have a not early stage but advanced stage of rheumatoid arthritis, unfortunately you have to use some allopathic medications. But it's nice, the overlapping. And thanks to the overlapping, a lot of universities are considering us, because we are not integralists, no? You know, this is important also to promote in your country this new concept of integrated medicine. We have some research ongoing, and also in pipeline. So really, it's a big, big effort. The 16 preclinical studies and the 20 overviews and reviews. These are just some of them. For people like me involved in pharmacology, this is something huge. Expert opinion on pharmacotherapy is something like the Bible for everybody is involved in pharmacology. Well, the editor of Expert Opinion on Pharmacotherapy published an overview on the studies with low-dose cytokines for vitiligo. When you are published on Expert Opinion on Pharmacotherapy, that means that you are really on the right way. Interesting also our cooperation with the Italian Society of Pediatrics. This is the magazine of the Italian Society of Pediatrics, and we have had the honor to be published for 3 times on this magazine. One about homeogriffi is the Italian name, Guna flu, for the prevention of recurrent respiratory infection, and another time about the use of low-dose cytokines, interleukin-12 and gamma interferon, in allergic diseases. So really something is changing under the sun of medicine. We reached these results because we started from a new concept in medicine. And if you agree, we can spend 15 minutes just to summarize the basis of PRN and to warm up. Please, as always, stop me in every second, every time you need to ask a question, or since some of you, friends, are already expert, why not to share with all the other colleagues your experiences? Always remember, and we'll be very synthetic, because you are, this is a privatissimum, so you are already expert, but never forget to refer your clinical therapeutical approach to the triangle of the therapy. This is what we do every time facing a patient, but also establishing a design for a clinical trial. Remember that the basis is always the drainage and the detoxification of the patient. Especially have in your mind the crucial role played by that wonderful medication that is Guna Matrix. Because since we release our low-dose cytokines through the blood capillary in the extracellular matrix, and these molecules have to reach the transmembrane receptors, if you have a toxic matrix, that in terms of histology mean an extracellular matrix that is dehydrated, that is, instead of in prevalent salt condition, a smooth, clean matrix, in prevalent gel condition, you will not allow the passage of communicating molecules, cytokines, hormones, neuropeptides, and growth factors, through the extracellular matrix to reach the cell. So, think in terms of product like matrix to boost every therapy, to enhance the activity of the signaling molecules. The yellow part of the triangle, that is the PNEI rebalancing. It is our heart of the therapy, the capability to act not only on the symptoms, but on the deep causes of every disease, that is the imbalance in the psycho-neuro-endocrine immune network. We are the only ones able to speak, to talk to the cells of this network. They only understand the language of signaling molecules. But signaling molecules for us are our medications. In this way, you recover the balance and you are acting on the cause and not only on the symptoms. We will focus today especially on the yellow and on the blue part of the therapy. How to use the messenger molecules, since they are the main actors of our medicine. Just to be very synthetic and easy, when you think in terms of psycho, neuro, endocrine, immune network, think for each of these three main homeostatic control systems in terms of scale, balances, because they work that way. We have to visualize every system like a scale. The first scale we study today is the immune system. When you speak about immune system, you always know that you are going to do something wrong, because if you are too easy, it is too easy. If you are a little complex, it is not complex, it is complicated. So I will try not to be too easy and not to be complicated, just to remember something about our immune system. First of all, I want to attract your attention on the crucial role played by the APCs, antigen presenting cells. We have several different types of APC, for instance, macrophages, Langerhans cells, but maybe the most important antigen presenting cell is the dendritic cell, the prince of all the APC. Which is the work done by the dendritic cells? They have to catch the antigen, to process the antigen, and to expose the some part of the antigen on their surface. This way, they present the antigen to the CD4 cell, that in this case is still a naive CD4 cell. Naive means they don't know what to do when they will be adult. According to the type of antigen presented by the dendritic cell, the naive CD4 cell will differentiate itself in specific T helper subsets. Th1, Th2, Th17, Treg. So, summarize this part. It is just a little scholastic part, but it's important to be all of us on the same line. Our immune system cells are so many, and they are part of big families. I want you to focus on two families of immune cells: CD4 plus cells, CD8 plus cells. From CD4, we are able to differentiate several Th subsets, especially Th1. They are involved in cell-mediated immune response. Th2, they are involved in humoral immune response. Treg, they are involved in immune tolerance. They don't trust each other, and they control each other in order to maintain an immune homeostasis. If Th1 are physiologically expressed, they are involved in cell-mediated immune response. But if they are overexpressed, they are responsible of inflammatory diseases. TH2, if they are normally physiologically expressed, they provide a very good humoral immune response. If they are overexpressed, they are responsible of atopy, allergic diseases. Treg, if they are physiologically expressed, they control TH1 and TH2, not to be too much exuberant, otherwise inflammation or allergy, immune tolerance. If they are overexpressed, they are responsible of some forms of immune deficiency. For instance, in the most part of oncological patients, you can observe an upregulation of Treg. Since Treg are so high, they downregulate TH1 and TH2, and that patient is living an immune suppression. From CD4, please remember also another very important T helper subset, that is TH17. They are the main responsible of autoimmune diseases. All the autoimmune diseases, Crohn's and ulcerative colitis, psoriasis and vitiligo, Hashimoto, thyroiditis and rheumatoid arthritis, and so on. They have been discovered in 2006, Cook and Bettelli, and they isolated the first TH17 in the pancreas because they are overexpressed in type 1 diabetes, that is an autoimmune disease. So, with this glance, you have a picture of CD4 cells. From CD8 cells, we differentiate a lot of cells, but two populations are the most important ones. And they are T cytotoxic cells. Thanks to them, we defend ourselves from viral infections. You remember, T cytotoxic cells are responsible of the specific cytolysis of a cell infected by the virus. But T cytotoxic cells are also responsible to kill cancer cells. So, good guys. From CD8 plus, we differentiate also T suppressor. How much important are T suppressors? Every day when we get up from our body, some millions of cells decide to de-differentiate themselves in a wrong way, and they can become cancer cells. Millions of cells. It's not a big quantity. Some million of cells, because my body contains 40,000 billion cells. Why every day I don't develop a cancer? Thanks to these guys. Because T suppressors. As soon as they see that a cell is de-differentiating itself in a wrong way, boom, they attack it. All these cells are related to each other. So, I leave this scheme on the flip chart because it's interesting sometimes to recall it. So, the dendritic cell presents the antigen to the naive according to the type of antigen, the naive, after the blastization, can become TH1, TH2, TH17, producing typical interleukins of every different type of T helper lymphocytes. Treg, they are there, controlling everything, taking down the exuberance of Th1 and Th2. We are able, with low-dose cytokines, to talk to Th2, Th1, Treg, telling them, hey guys, wake up if they are a little lazy. Or to say to them, take it easy if they are overexpressed. I mean, here, not here, because we are not in Guna, we are at Ramada. Okay, here in Milan, at Guna Laboratories, we did a discovery that is really interesting. And it is how the cells of our body talk each other. The language used by the cells, and it is the language of signaling molecules. And in our laboratories, we also discovered the volume used by the cells to communicate each other. And it is a very low volume. I mean, it's a very low concentration. So it's beautiful to have the possibility to whisper to the cells, to recover the physiology of that cell. Every disease is an expression of too much or too little activity or of these cells. With the right words, we can recover the homeostasis. In terms of balance, this is a very easy representation of the immune system, because you have seen how many different cells, and they are just a little part, we have in our immune system. This is a picture of an immune system that is in healthy condition. Th1, inflammation, Th2, allergy, are on the same level. I mean, they are in an homeostatic concentration. That's good. This is the immune system I have now in my body, I think. This is an imbalance, for instance, with upregulation of Th2 and downregulation of Th1. This is the typical picture of the 20% of your patients in Europe, but also in other parts of the world. 20% of the population is allergic. On the other side, Th1 and sometimes Th17 upregulated, Th2, Treg downregulated. This is the picture of your patient with an inflammatory disease, and if Th17 are involved, autoimmune inflammatory disease. It's very nice, the picture, the image of the immune system has a scale, because it will be very easy to understand the strategy we apply to recover the homeostasis, to recover the balance between the different scales of that scale. We have, for instance, in this case, to downregulate Th2 and to upregulate Th1. Easy. Yes, you are thinking, Alessandro, how can be easy? How can I tell Th2, take it easy? Our immune system has this word, take it easy. It's an interleukin. Gamma interferon is the word, hey guy, slow down. There is another word produced by the alphabet of the immune system, that is ATH1, come on. That word is interleukin 12. So, under the form of cytokines, hormones, neuropeptides, growth factors, we reproduce the alphabet of our body under the form of medications. In allergy, Th2 upregulated, if they are upregulated, they produce too much of some of their interleukins. Interleukin 4, interleukin 5, interleukin 13. They are not good nor bad. If they are in our body in the homeostatic concentration, they work perfectly. For instance, interleukin 5, when in the physiological concentration, is able to kill parasites. L means oxure, I don't know in English, oxures. If it is overexpressed, has in allergy, interleukin 5 stimulate eosinophils. But if you stimulate eosinophils, you are sustaining the chronicity of an allergy, especially a respiratory allergy. So it's important to control the concentration of these interleukins in our body. The big bastard in allergy is the interleukin 4 anyway. Eh? It is the interleukin 4 that stimulates Th2. Interleukin 4 too much. It stimulates B lymphocytes. Look how all the different cells talk each other. In this case, when you have an allergy, you are yelling the B lymphocytes, hey, please produce IgE. Normally, you produce just 2% of IgE. But if someone yell you, you start producing a lot, a storm of IgE. IgE sensitizes the mast cell, second contact with the allergen, degranulation of histamine, and you have the symptoms. You have great medications for that. Antihistaminic, oh my God. Corticosteroids. You can use the specific immune therapy, the allergic vaccine. But if you want not to treat the allergic symptoms, but to cure, maybe, your patient, I mean to recover the balance between Th1 and Th2, you have to talk to Th2. We are the only ones in the pharmaceutical world environment able, through medication, to talk to Th2, telling them, take it easy. Gamma interferon, okay? So this is the concept we apply. Today we will speak a lot about inflammation. Inflammation is the other side of the moon of the immune system. In the previous case, allergy, we had Th2 upregulated. In inflammatory diseases, we have Th1 and Th17. Since Th1 and Th17 are overexpressed, they are producing not more the right quantity of these poor cytokines, but plus, 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 too much. Is the plus, plus, plus responsible of inflammatory signs and symptoms. These are the main cytokines involved in inflammatory diseases. We are going to study them very, very deeply, since our research is based mainly on diseases which are inflammatory diseases. We will know everyone very well.
Can I ask a question?
Absolutely.
What role does Treg play in your last two slides? Do you know when Th1 is high and Th2 is low and vice versa?
Okay, yeah, absolutely. You can have two evidence, two cases. First, you have a down regulation of Treg. So both Th1 and Th2 are overexpressed. Or, other case, Treg are working normally, okay? So they are in the condition, through especially TGF-beta, to downregulate Th1, but the trigger of inflammation is so strong, for instance, a very severe infection, that even though you have a good control expressed by Treg, Th1 are obliged to work too much. Why? Because a lot of viruses, a lot of bacteria, or a very strong trauma affected myself. So the other expression of TH substance depends by a not good work of Treg or slash and the importance of the trigger of inflammation. Okay?
And can you, would it help to upregulate Treg? Because you don't talk.
Absolutely, yes. You can upregulate Treg or you can downregulate Treg. The concept of up and down regulation can be applied to all the different subsets. Okay? If you need to upregulate Treg, you have to use TGF-beta. If you want to downregulate Treg, I will show you our clinical study on cancer, you must use interleukin 12. So every time you have one or more than one cytokine to stimulate or to downregulate. We have a scheme, very easy, where you have the so-called opposite cytokine. Okay, this is another picture of the immune system that is typical of your kids with recurrent respiratory infections, chronic tonsillitis. You know that recurrent respiratory infections means that that kid, 3-4 years, between September and April, show over 6 episodes of tonsillitis. And how do we manage that type of kid? Amoxicillin and clavulanic acid every month. So we are repping his immune system. You have to recover the balance. Since those infections are due to a lack in the cell-mediated immune response, we have to push the Th1 answer. And we have to slow down the Th2 immune suppressing activity. Th2 and Treg. Okay, so it's always this concept of recovery the balance. This is the homeostasis I was speaking about. In a healthy condition, all the cytokines, the hormones, the neuropeptides, the growth factors are in a range of concentration that is a precise range. A physiological range of concentration, picograms, femtograms. If you have some cytokines over concentrated, I mean here, you will have an inflammation. If you have the Th2 and Treg cytokines overexpressed, you will have an immune decline. So have this image of homeostasis as referring point to understand what do we consider as physiological and as pathological. Over or down expression of some cytokines. Our therapeutic strategy will be to recover that physiological concentration. Look at this slide. This is very nice because I have a little animation. In healthy conditions, you have both Th1 and Th2 anti-Treg cytokines in the physiological concentration. Picograms, femtograms per milliliter. This is, if you make a blood test in this moment from me, I have interleukin 1, 2, 3, 4, blah, 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 here. What happened when a trigger attacked my body? Stress, viruses, bacteria, traumas, I don't know. This concentration disappeared, and you have an imbalance. Before, excuse me, look here. Before physiological, Th1 cytokines, Th2 cytokines. Disappear the physiological concentration and a pathological concentration appears. You have no more physiological, but up over concentration of the red cytokines. It means from Th1, pro-inflammatory cytokines, interleukin-1, interleukin-6 expression. TNF-alpha, interleukin-17, if you are facing a patient with rheumatoid arthritis or diabetes type 1. If you have these cytokines overexpressed, up, unfortunately you have these cytokines, TGF-beta, interleukin-4, interleukin-10, that we can consider as anti-inflammatory cytokines, down-expressed. When you have a kid with recurrent tonsillitis, this is the picture of his cytokines. The red ones are down, so Th1 are not working well. So he doesn't have a good cell-mediated immune response front to fight against bacteria. And he has an overexpression of interleukin-4 and interleukin-10 that are, when overexpressed, immune-suppressive cytokines. So it's always a balance between Th1, Th2, in this moment just Th1, Th2, otherwise it's too complicated. It's sufficient to understand what we are going to do now. This is a very important slide by a methodological point of view. Please look at the reference. Cytokine 2014. Cytokine is a journal. It is a Bible for all the immunologists, which is the concept that cytokine wants to express. Hey, no good, neither good nor bad in nature. For instance, now I'm going to tell you that interleukin-1 is responsible of acute inflammation. Interleukin-6 is really a bastard anyway. Interleukin-6 is responsible of chronic inflammatory disease. I have to tell you something sad. I will die. It's sad for me, I hope also for you. I will die. And if I don't have a crash with my car, if I don't have a contact with Ebola virus, I will die because of interleukin-6. Interleukin-6 is responsible of chronic inflammatory disease. It is responsible of aging. But the poor interleukin-6, he is neither good nor bad. When it is in the physiological concentration, interleukin-6 is absolutely indispensable to activate Th1 to fight against viruses and bacteria. When overexpressed, it is responsible of the chronic inflammation. My skin will become aged because of interleukin-6. So it's important, my friend, that you will consider this concept. Neither good nor bad. They are bad when are here or here. They are good playing a physiological role when they are in a physiological concentration, picograms, femtograms. Our therapeutic goal will be to recover this space, this range, this homeostasis. We can do that. And this is the most beautiful therapy because you are supporting the self-healing. We are able both to be sick and to be perfectly healed. Self-healing. We address the self-healing through the right words and the right volume. If diseases are expressions, consequences of changed concentration here or here of signaling molecules, okay, it's clear. What can I do to recover the homeostasis? Is it possible to support a deficiency? Or is it possible to slow down, to block an excess? Yes, it is. Antagonistic cytokines are utilized in order to slow down an excess of activity, and the same cytokine or hormone, with Dr. Passafaro you will see also the use of hormones, to slow down according to the negative feedback that we studied in physiology, an excess, or to support according to a positive feedback, a deficiency. It's absolutely linear, logical, and we refer to physiology. The concept to understand the use of antagonistic cytokine is expressed in this wonderful paper from Cook and Bettelli, Review of Diabetic Study, 2006, and Current Opinion in Immunology, 2007, when these two guys spoke in terms of cross-regulation, how to explain in a very easy way the concept of cross-regulation. Do you remember in the 80s, Gorbachev and Reagan? The Cold War is the same. These are Americans. These are Russians. American says, hey, look that I have the atomic bomb, interleukin-4, that is able to destroy you, downregulate you. Gorbachev, look that I have the hydrogen bomb that is able to destroy you. The name of the hydrogen bomb is gamma interferon. Thanks to the Cold War, for 50 years we didn't have wars in our countries, more or less. The same in the immune system. Th1 don't trust Th2, so they say, look that I can destroy you. The same Th2. If they are both strong, no war, physiology. If some of these two guys is too strong, war, disease that can be inflammation or can be allergy. They control each other. So why not to reproduce these same mechanisms, providing from abroad the same cytokine has medication, yes, but there is only one company in the world able to prepare the bombs in the right concentration, and we are. That's the reason why we work with this patient, because we are pacifists. Love and peace. Only using the right concentration, love and peace, otherwise you give antibiotics, it's a bomb. Sometimes you need to bomb that area, but the most part you have to think in this way. So cross-regulation. This is so true. Every slide has a reference, it's nice also for you. This is a clinical and diagnostic laboratory immunology, November 1997. I don't know those guys. But they arrive to the same, they reach the same goal of our researches. What did they do? They said that using interleukin-4, look here, interleukin-4 is able to downregulate Th1. Is it okay? Mm-hmm. Okay. If you use interleukin-4 at 1 picogram per milliliter, it's our concentration. You are able not to destroy Th1, but to to reduce the activity of TH1 for the 50%. What does it mean? That if your TH1 are here, using a low dose, you don't destroy TH1, but you put them again in the peace space. That's huge. I want to know Patricia Mendez Samperio et al. Because they are going exactly in the same direction of ours. I mean, this is the mainstream pharmacology in our year 2016. Everybody is working on that direction, but we have the advantage to already have the solution under the form of medication. You have in your papers, in your book, in your syllabus, I hope also in your scientific materials in the different countries, this scheme that is a perfect summary about how to use the cytokines. Look, here in this column you have the cytokine. Every disease is an expression of up or down regulation of these molecules. If you want to strengthen the same cytokine, you use as Guna medication that cytokine. Easy, you don't have to be a genius. You have to be a genius to discover which is the opposing cytokine. I mean the cytokine able to reduce the concentration of another cytokine overexpressed. For instance, if you want to downregulate the interleukin that make you becoming elderly, if you want to be healthy and beautiful, you must block interleukin 6. Not block, you must recover the homeostatic concentration. Who is able to do that until you can tell? I am always under Guna matrix and interleukin 10, since I have to preserve my image. And it's really the best anti-aging therapy. It's not something strange. Drain the matrix and contrast, downregulate interleukin 6. That's the best contract with nature to be always young and strong. Drainage detoxification. I don't want to spend so much time because several times in your countries we focus on this concept. Please don't, I'm going very fast, you are expert. Never forget that this tissue is the most important tissue we have in our body. It is the extracellular matrix, the space between the external environment and the hardware of our tissues, which are the cells. Why is so important to drain the extracellular matrix? Because, my friend, when you provide Guna interleukin 10, you release interleukin 10 through the blood capillary in this space. Unfortunately, because of pollution, not right nutrition, stresses, synthetic drugs, we have an overload of toxins in the extracellular matrix. If you look at an extracellular matrix of your kids, 10 years old, 5 years old, that extracellular matrix is like a transparent gel, super hydrated. Since it is in that condition, all the molecules can make this beautiful journey to the transmembrane receptors, bringing the right instruction to the cell to work in the physiological way. If you have a toxic extracellular matrix, after 40 years old, everybody start having a change in the extracellular matrix. Instead of a transparent gel, it becomes like a thick. Day after day, more thick. You don't allow the passages of the of the signaling molecules. So the cell asks you, hey, what I have to do, please? I don't know apoptosis. For instance, here you have fat cells. Why around 35 the first wrinkles start appearing? For instance, in women, you start reducing your estrogens signaling molecules, which is the activity of estrogens. Many, and they also have a liposynthetic action. It means that when estrogens produced by your ovaries impact the fat cells, the message is, hey guys, please be hyperplastic. When you have hyperplastic fat cell in the extracellular matrix of the skin, that is the derm, those fat cells, together with collagen fibers, are the wonderful bioscaffold that sustains the superficial layer of the skin. 37 years old, 40 years old, it's normal, estrogens goes down, and in the same time, the matrix is toxic, more toxic, because 40 years of life, less estrogens, more toxic extracellular matrix, that estrogens don't arrive to the fat cells. The fat cells, instead of to be hyperplastic, collapse a little. If it is collapsed, the superficial layer collapse. And when you live with a woman, and she is around 38, 39 years old, and you are having breakfast in your kitchen, and she is in the bathroom, and you listen to her yelling, don't worry. She's not falling down. She look at the mirror the first wrinkle. So clean the matrix, and you will allow the passage of hormones, of serotonin or interleukins. And since after 50 years old, imagine that until 50 years old, interleukin 6 is in this level. Even though you are the healthiest man of the world, after 50, boom, it goes up. If you want to live for a long time, block interleukin 6 overexpressed after 50. The only solution is Guna interleukin 10. Interleukin 6 damages mitochondria. So that's the reason why we become hot. So this is just to laugh, but not to laugh. Guna matrix and interleukin 10, that's really the best anti-modern aging therapy. It's obvious. Why so important, and this is the topic of today, to manage inflammatory diseases, to use Guna matrix. Because if you don't drain, look at this faucet, the only possibility that the body has to fight against the loading of this big quantity of toxins is to turn on the inflammation. But if you turn off the inflammation, you have symptoms of inflammation. Look how smart he is to open the faucets for the unloading of this overload of toxins. In this way, you don't ask your body to turn on the inflammatory mechanism to contrast the toxins. I mean, Guna matrix is a wonderful anti-inflammatory drug in case of chronic inflammations. It's really, for me, a masterpiece of drug. And we know everything about Guna matrix. You can see in this scheme all the components. This is interesting. Look, it contains interleukin 6. Oh my God, Alessandro, you just said that interleukin 6 is responsible of chronic inflammatory diseases. Yes, when it is overexpressed. If you provide the physiological, precise, good concentration, 10 femtograms per milliliter, this interleukin 6 does something that is important to clean your body. It activates metalloproteases. Metalloproteases are those enzymes that, for instance, together with hyaluronidases, make the gel condition of the extracellular matrix again in sol condition. I mean, you come back in your age thanks to the interleukin 6, if in physiological concentration. And a lot of other components that all together work moving the toxins from the extracellular matrix and vicariating them through the lymphatic vessel. I mean, Guna matrix is a complete medication to clean all the body, bringing the toxins from the extracellular matrix through the lymphatic capillary towards the excretion organs. When you want to boost the effect of every therapy, not only an homeopathic therapy, the effect of benzodiazepines in your patients, the effect of antibiotics in your patients, add Guna matrix. You understand it well. Every medication is released here. Eh? If you have a toxic matrix, you need more benzodiazepines. That's the reason why you start with 10 drops of Valium and you arrive to 30 drops of Valium. If you want to come back to 10 drops of Valium, not gallium, Valium, okay? Clean the matrix. Okay, you know everything about drainage. I just want to, excuse me, okay, matrix is here. I want to show you this medication that sometimes we don't consider in the right way. Guna cell. Guna cell contains ingredients to enhance the activity of the mitochondria, to increase the oxidative phosphorylation. The results will be that we will have more ATP. Look that during aging you have a lack of ATP. And since in chronic inflammatory diseases you have high level of interleukin 6 and interleukin 6 damages mitochondria, always when you treat a patient with a chronic inflammatory disease, think of Guna cell. Because you need to support the mitochondria activity. And please, for all the friends who comes from homeopathy, look at these ingredients. Colchicum autumnale, conium maculatum, podophyllum peltatum, that are the three most important herbs or homeopathic remedies for degenerative diseases and cancer. And thanks to the big genius of Hans-Erik Rekebeck, methylglyoxal. Methylglyoxal is something huge to stimulate the mitochondria. So, Guna cell is not only to produce more ATP, but is the strongest anti-degenerative medication we have in our range. Since we are going to speak about chronic inflammatory diseases, never forget, besides the single specific cytokines, matrix and cell. Cell and matrix. You will have much more effects than using only the single cytokines. Okay. Inflammation, the common matrix of the research. We spend some minutes before the break focusing on inflammation. I'm convinced that if we are able to manage in the right way the inflammation, really we can treat 80% of all the diseases. And this is something that not only we say, but really the mainstream medicine. Time, that is not a scientific magazine, everybody knows this cover, and the secret killer. If you don't manage the inflammation, you will have a progression of the disease. We know that from pathology, from physiology. Inflammation, metaplasia, dysplasia, neoplasia. I mean, if you don't treat, if you don't manage the inflammation, you have the progression of disease towards the degeneration. In that was really a genius Hans Erik Rekkeveg with the six phase table, not the vicariation. And the vicariation is due to and not good management of the inflammation that start acute and then the progression. With modern terms, now we say metaplasia, dysplasia, neoplasia. Not nice. In terms of cytokines, since inflammation is a PNEI phenomenon, but especially an immune phenomenon, it means led by interleukins, which are the interleukins involved in the inflammatory process, and which are the interleukins then under the form of Guna medications we can use. The most important pro-inflammatory interleukins are interleukin 1, acute inflammation, we will see. Interleukin 6, chronic inflammation. TNF-alpha, acute autoimmune inflammation. Interleukin 8, but it is not so bad. What we can do to recover the homeostatic concentration of interleukin 1 when interleukin 1 is here, how to bring it here? Guna anti-interleukin 1, Guna interleukin 10. How to block the big bastard, interleukin 6? Guna interleukin 10. How to control TNF-alpha? Infliximab. Yeah, good. It is a monoclonal antibody against TNF-alpha. It works in a wonderful way. There is a little problem that the patient under anti-TNF-alpha infliximab, they don't have more pain in their joint if they have a rheumatoid arthritis, but the first mycoplasma, the first bacteria passing in this room, it affects him. And since they have blocked all the Th1 activity, cell-mediated immune response, why? Because TNF-alpha is neither good nor bad. In the right concentration is a wonderful activator of Th1. It becomes bad when overexpressed. If you block all the TNF-alpha, your patient will not have more pain, but he will die of pneumonia, maybe. If you use the right concentration of anti-interleukin 1 plus together combined interleukin 10, you are recovering the physiological concentration of TNF-alpha. I mean the association Guna anti-interleukin 1 plus Guna interleukin 10 is a model anti-TNF-alpha, is the model infliximab. Very interesting. So with a few products you can manage all the different type of
inflammation, acute chronic autoimmune. This is the bag of the tools that never you have to forget. All of them are in drops. Guna anti-interleukin 1, Guna interleukin 10. We will see when to use Guna interleukin 4. I already say to you, in autoimmune diseases, this is an interesting interleukin. It is the most powerful interleukin to control and downregulate Th17. Do you remember Th17? Autoimmune diseases. If you want to keep them down, it is interleukin 4. TGF-beta, you ask me, how can enhance the activity of Treg, TGF-beta. You have a patient. This is an usual question during the seminars. Okay, Alessandro, it's very clear, Th1, Th2. Th2 allergy, Th1 inflammation. Yes, but sometimes you ask me, we face patient with, in the same time, an allergy and inflammation. So what I have to do? If the patient in the same time has an allergic asthma and a psoriasis, it means that he has upregulated both Th2 and Th1. It means that both of them are here. If both of them are here, what does it mean? That guy has Treg that are a little lazy. So, first of all, Guna TGF-beta to down-regulate both Th1 and Th2. And then you start treating the most severe disease. Is it clear? That's a typical management, patient management with this type of picture. Another great medication, Guna Beta Endorphin. Guna Beta Endorphin. When you have to manage a benign, acute or chronic pain, for instance, muscle skeletal pain, think of beta endorphin. Beta endorphin, you remember very well, derives from propiomelanocortin. I mean, it is an opioid. And why it's so interesting? Because beta endorphin works both on the peripheral path of pain and central path of pain. So it's really very effective. It's really very effective. And you see that there is an empty spot here. We are speaking about the bag of tools to manage every inflammatory disease. What can we put here in this empty spot? Which other Guna medication you can think of? Phlam. Why phlam? Phlam is the North Star of every anti-inflammatory treatment. Because we will see, if you go into Guna phlam, we will find anti-interleukin 1, interleukin 10, beta endorphin, TGF-beta. I mean, you have, under the form of a unique product, all the actors for the management of the inflammation. Guna phlam is okay for acute, subacute, chronic degenerative inflammatory diseases. So if you don't know from which one start from that.
But is it better if you did know, to focus on interleukin 1? Is that better? If you're sure what you're doing.
Absolutely, yeah. Or you will see in half an hour a secret that is how to combine Guna phlam plus the single cytokines according to the timing of the inflammation. In that way, really, your patient will shift towards the health in a very quick way. But sometimes, by phone, what can you suggest? You don't know, you don't see your patient. Never with Guna phlam, you will be wrong. then you can intervene in a specific way according to the timing. That is exactly what we are going to see. But now, just to make our extracellular matrix more toxic, there is the coffee break. So now you will shift towards the gel condition of your extracellular matrix and then Guna matrix to clean. Okay? And then we will see.
I'm so loving it.